Yo, what's good? Good morning. It's your boy Coach Sean here. Headed to the gym bright and early Sunday morning. I've been up. I woke up about 5:30 today and made myself go back to sleep. That's that auto natural body alarm. So I wake up about 4:30 every morning during the week, including Saturdays. And Sunday is like my day off from training. Training clients, so I try to get up a little later, but I force myself to go back to sleep so I can get a little more Z. So we're looking at about 7 right now, but a little cloudy out here. I wanted to hit you with question and answers plus part 2 of last Sunday's Show the Bus Down. So this question and answer comes from Brian. Brian wants to know if I eat the same thing every day. And what do I eat? The answer to your question, Brian, is yes, I do. I'm a simple guy. I'm not difficult by any means. I'm not hard to please. Eating the same thing every day does not bother me one bit. In addition to the fact that I don't have much of a variety I can choose from, simply from the way that I eat. So I don't eat any hybridized foods, meaning a man-made, a natural hybridization. Of course, that happens and that's fine, but anything that man takes the genes, splices them together to create a brand new type of food or vegetable, I try to stay away from. I don't eat any genetically modified foods. That's to include my supplements. But, you know, going out to eat, friends and family every now and then, yeah, you know, how many restaurants out there serve non-genetically modified foods? Let's be real. So, and of course, 9 times out of 10, that's going to be a cheat meal. So I'll make up for it. I'll compensate. I'll do some extra cardio, whatever, to burn something off. But I still stick to healthy eating. So anyway, what are we looking at? For my full course meals, meaning like, you know, lunch and dinners, for my protein, I eat chickpeas. I'll pressure cook them. And I'll, you know, dice up some bell peppers, some onions, maybe some okra, whatever. I make it really, really good. I use, for seasoning, I'll use Flavor God, cayenne pepper, maybe if I do some salt on my own, it'll definitely be just a dash of sea salt or pink salt. But, and for a veggie, I like to do spinach. I love spinach. I don't mind spinach at all. For salad, romaine, definitely romaine, maybe even a mixture of spinach and romaine salad. As for my shakes, I do hemp protein. It doesn't have a flavor at all. It's original. You can find it on my website. You can purchase that item singly, or you can purchase it within a program package. But anyway, real good protein, and I'll add my kale, my blueberries to that to give it some flavor. And then for snacks, you know, I'll do, of course, I love fruit. I do fruit. Mangoes is real good. Mangoes helps to regulate your hormones real good in the evening time too. You know, your levels start to drop. So maintain those. And apples, peaches, melons. I just love fruit. I'll do seaweed snacks. Seaweed snacks is real good. I have Gopal snacks that I eat, which you can also find on my website. I have an all-natural brownie bar. That's a real good snack. It'll satisfy your taste buds if you got sweet tooth for things like Snicker bars and Oreos and stuff like that. Okay, and the brownies that aren't so good. But that's about it, man. I do my chickpeas, but I gotta say I'm bipolar, because every now and then I'll bounce from being a vegan to a vegetarian, meaning I'll throw in egg whites. And I only do that because I have an intolerance to chickpeas, depending on how my body is reacting. You know, I may get experience excessive bloating, which is very uncomfortable, and it hides your abs. So to compensate, I'll do some egg whites. I have to say, after my colon surgery, I haven't had that experience. So I've only had eggs, I want to say twice, and that was just going out to breakfast and brunch with some friends. That's it. So other than that, I've been full vegan thus far. So that's a good thing, right? So yeah, so the question and answer, Brian, I hope I answered. And hey, I'm about to hit this gym. I'll be pulling up any second now. And in the meantime, if you got questions, I got answers. Hit my website, CoachShawnFitness.com. Click the contacts tab and type your question. And I'll respond via video at some point. And check out everything else. Look at my distant culture programs. That's going to help you to determine what's best for your body, what works and what does not work, what exercise you should be doing to meet your goals. Personal training, I'm here for you, one-on-one, if you're in the area. You have to be in the Albany or Atlanta area, though. All right? And other than that, I got meal and fitness guys, for those that know how to follow direction. It's real Barney. Break everything down so you can understand it, and you can do everything on your own. But I have to say, the personal training and the distant coaching, they include all of the above. Program packages, they got everything. They got the supplements, they got the meal and fitness guides, and it's got the coaching, all right? So, here we go. This is a recap from last Sunday with that shoulder bust down. Y'all check it out. We'll be right back.